I have been working in the cultural tourism field for many years and never really believed the numbers that were being bandied about. Official figures were 1/3 of tourists were cultural tourists. Some other studies said 80% of American domestic tourists were cultural tourists. And some of the other figures were really quite astounding. And it took a long time to figure out what they were really talking about. And what they were really talking about was that anybody who visited an attraction that might be considered as a cultural heritage attraction at any time during their trip was categorized as a cultural tourist. And we know there's a huge difference between what you do when you travel and why you travel. And so through a series of studies that we did, we came up with a framework that said, let's see if we can segment the cultural tourism market by looking at the importance of cultural tourism as a motive to travel, as well as a depth of experience. Motive should be fairly straightforward. Some people travel primarily to learn about another destination's cultural heritage. For some other people, it's part of the bundle of reasons why they travel. So it's not the main reason, but it is one of the reasons. But also for many other people, they may visit cultural attractions even though cultural heritage wasn't a reason why they traveled. And one of the reasons is that so many of a destination's attractions fit into the cultural basket. And they may consume them as sightseeing tourists or pleasure tourists. The dimension of looking at depth of experience also recognizes that people, for a variety of reasons, can have fundamentally different experiences based on knowledge, based on interest, based on group size, based on group dynamics, based on a whole range of things. And some people may have a much deeper experience than others. Some others may have a shallow experience, isn't the best word, but an experience that's mostly sightseeing and just experiencing the landscape. And so by combining these two dimensions of centrality of purpose and depth of experience, we were able to come up with five different types of cultural tourist. Purposeful cultural tourist is somebody who travels primarily because of cultural heritage assets of the destination and also has a deep experience. The sightseeing cultural tourist is somebody who travels out of an interest in learning about a destination's cultural heritage, but mostly has a fairly shallow, a sightseeing-oriented experience. Then there's also the casual cultural tourist, where culture plays one of the many reasons why they travel, but their experience is generally quite shallow, quite sightseeing-oriented. The fourth type is the incidental cultural tourist, where culture plays no role in their reason to travel to a destination, and yet they participate in cultural tourist activities. And we found, for example, that a lot of business travelers will visit cultural attractions or museums when they're traveling, but really the reason why they go to a destination is because of business. And then the fifth category that we came up with was what we call the serendipitous cultural tourist, where culture played no role in the reason why they traveled to a destination, but they ended up visiting a cultural place and had quite a deep cultural experience. And the sightseeing casual tourist, again, will represent a small percent, significant minority, but that most so-called cultural tourists fall into the casual and incidental category. The long-haul tourist is much more likely to be interested in learning about a destination's cultural heritage, and they tend to be disproportionately in the purposeful or sightseeing segment. The short-haul tourist is traveling primarily for leisure, recreation, and fun, and so they may visit cultural attractions, but really for their entertainment potential. And so they tend to fit much more in the casual and the incidental categories. There are very different consumption patterns between the purposeful, the sightseeing, the casual, and the incidental cultural tourist, even at the same site. So, for example, at forts in Northern Europe, the casual incidental cultural tourist is much more interested in the architecture of the fort, whereas the purposeful cultural tourist is much more interested in the history and the story behind the fort. Work that's been done in other places has looked at how people use different media, how they spend different amounts of time at attractions, how they the level of pre-planning is different, and even that the types of information that they search for is quite different.